3D is our business, but at Expand, we like to ask ourselves, do we know everything there is to know about how we as a society can use 3D? We might be inclined to think we do. That's what our brain prefers to do. But seriously, at this panel called The Big Picture, I really want to tell you about the bigger picture. I want to tell you about how we, in Expand, look at 3D, not just as a technology, but as a human capability, and put it out of the box. Improvement in content production, like 120 FPS recording cameras, improvement in rendering, auto stereoscopy, 4K, 8K, laser projections, OLEDs, curved screens, holograms. This is all still thinking very much in the box. This might be better off as a semi-confidential secret, but at Expand, we are lucky to be a bunch of eccentrics. When there's a straight line, we run right through it, jump over it, and push its boundaries. So when you say 3D, we don't just think of 3D cinema, or watching 3D TV at home, or playing a 3D video game. We do not think of 3D glasses, and we do not think of auto stereoscopy. These are technologies. And 3D is not a technology. It's a concept. That's how we are thinking about it. And when we talk 3D, we think of the brain. I mean, what would be the high-tech equivalent of millions of years of evolution that resulted in the brain's capacity to keep the lights on each time we blink so that our world doesn't go dark approximately 20,000 times a day? Now that's a bigger picture. In Expand, we do love entertainment. It's the shortest way to at least a temporary feeling of happiness. It's the shortest way to jolt the brain into content buzzing, idea making, and emotional fulfillment. But there's more to 3D than entertainment. We think education. We think students, from elementary to university, as well as professional training, military simulations, training of surgeons, simulations of complicated surgeries. When we look at the bigger picture, we do not only see education and professional training. Our people at Expand have come up with the most amazing ideas with running left and right of the line. This year, we will see the first medical device that is based on the same technology that brings magic into 3D cinema. Expand Amblets is as simple as using glasses, like a device for children with amblyopia. 3 to 5% of kids suffer from it. You've never heard of amblyopia? That's okay. I'm sure you've heard much more about ADHD. Again, with technology that made Avatar such an amazing cinema experience, we are able to treat ADHD. Simple, uninvasive, no side effects, and out of the box. And so, we continue to ask questions. Can we help prefrontal cortex? This center of human morale, empathy, and creativity to expand? And can we come up with a solution to its tendency to penetrate very fast? Can we help improve workplace productivity by using technologies that bring us 3D? On an even more fantastical note, can we, by stimulation of nerves, break the blood-brain barrier? Can we stimulate the brain to produce effective neural connections? Can we help it wrinkle up and make us smarter? I'm not saying we can, but we can open the door towards challenging the brain and asking deeper questions. So we don't just know the big picture vision of 3D or its potential. Yes, 3D in entertainment and cinema will stay, but we will continue to explore the capacity of the brain in our 3D world to advance into a more exciting and immersive reality.